Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to another course. In this one, I will show you how you can create a virtual iOS joystick for Swift in SpriteKit. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay. We are going to create an analog joystick for Swift, and you can use it in your SpriteKit games. But before we do that, I have told you a few videos ago that I'm going to show you what I'm creating for a client, and it is ready. It is called Swimming Stickman. So today I'm going to show you Swimming Stickman and we are going to take it from there. So go ahead and click the link down in the description for Swimming Stickman and you can take a look at the game that we have just created. And as you can see, it's a Swimming Stickman that is swimming through a dungeon-like cave. And it has to avoid some obstacles, get some coins while the water levels are rising. Okay, now this was the first idea of my client, and then we took it even further, and that is Tank Quest Mania. Go ahead and download it from the App Store from the link down below. Now in Tank Quest Mania, we wanted to do even a more exciting game, and we added a joystick, and of course we added some more tanks. The idea of this one is that the fire level isn't actually rising, but the gameplay is of course going from top to bottom, and we are firing with the tanks. So let me just show you how this game looks right now. Okay, I will build it on my iPhone 10, and let us just show you what we have here. Okay, let's wait for it, and I will show you while demonstrating this app how this joystick works, and after that we are going to build it out with an example code, of course, so you may use it in your own apps. Okay, it is building up. Let's wait for that. Build ecstasy has succeeded, and now let us just wait for it, and let me just cancel it out and go back here and tap on that. Okay, here we have our landing first screen, so let me just go there. And if I just move this joystick around, you can see the tank is following the orientation and it is of course moving. Okay, and now let us just fire it off. Okay, here we have it. Oh, and once we do get hit by these obstacles, of course we die. Let me just show you once again. So we may go, and as you can see, the nose of the tank aligns with the orientation of our movement. Okay, let me just go there a bit further. Okay, there we go. Real awesome stuff. Okay, let's just go back here. Oh, and we are finished. Okay, now that is the game, and today I'm going to show you how you can create that analog joystick in Swift and for SpriteKit. Now let me just go back to our Chrome here, and here I have created a starter repository. Go ahead and go to my GitHub account, or just go to this joystick tank repository. Of course, I will link the repository down below. It is github.com/developer/joystick-tank if you are interested in saying that out loud. So go ahead and clone it or download it, and you will be presented with this project that I'm going to go through real quick right now. So as always, I have removed the main.storyboard and deleted it all together and removed it from our main interface here. And then I have added inside AppDelegate these four lines of codes that initiate our view controller. And here is our view controller. That is pretty simple. Basically, we create an SK view and then we set its frame to our whole screen. Of course, we use some extensions. Go ahead and take a look at that. So we have a screen size extension and a scale to extension that I will cover in just a minute. So we set our frames, our frame to the screen size width and a screen size is height. So this will be always regardless of our device. Okay, now next up is to add a scene to our SK view, and that is our gameplay that I will just skip right over to now. And here we have a background and a hero, and inside our did move to view, I have set up our nodes, basically set the anchor point to 0.0 and 0.0, basically at the center of our screen, and added our background and our hero. Okay, and here we have some Z position set up, just the basics. Go ahead and take a deeper look, but that is basically it. Now let us just run our app here on our iPhone. Well, let's select our iPhone 10 device here and let us just run this. Okay, let's cancel that out. Sometimes Xcode doesn't really allow us, maybe it is because of the recording, but as you can see here, I have the Joystick Tank app, so I will just go into that. And it is a pretty simple interface, just a background and a tank. If we tap on it or move anything, nothing really happens. So what we are going to do now for our analog joystick implementation is to go to this GitHub repository from Mitrov-D, I believe it is spelled correctly, and download the analogjoystick.swift file. And if you just go through his documentation, then you will see that it is very, very flexible. We are going to use this with our images. So let's go back to our Xcode project. And as you can see, here it is our analogjoystick.swift file. Okay, and now we are going to add it in. And let me just take a little peek to our assets folder. Here I have the background, our hero, and a joystick, and a joy substrate. Now the substrate is the background of the joystick and the joystick is actually the one that we are going to move. Okay, let's go back to the gameplay and finally implement our analog joystick. Now first of all, we need to add our analog joystick, okay? And of course we need to create first of all our joystick, so I would just comment that out. So let JS analog joystick and choose with the diameter, and you could choose anything from one to whatever you like. I set it for the diameter of 100 points. Now you could add colors if you wanted. I will choose neon this time, and the substrate will be of course the background, and the stick will be the joystick that I have created earlier, I have shown you. Now, next up, we simply need to position it. And I will use this screen size width extension that I have created, and you can see it in the extensions.swift file. And basically we are putting it half of the width down, and we are adding the joystick's radius plus 45, and that will put our analog joystick about 45 pixels above the bottom of our screen, because remember, we are setting the anchor point of our scene to be at the center, so that is why we need to set minus half of the width. And for the height, for the width, this is it, and for the height, the same as for the bottom, and for the width, it starts from the left. I got a little bit confused, but you get the idea. We are putting it at the bottom left corner of our screen. And we set our Z position to be above everything else. Here it is. And then we return this joystick. So we may set up our joystick, and this is set in a separate function. And we add our analog joystick to our scene. So let's build and run that and see how that looks. So let me just see here. Okay, let's cancel that out. Of course, this will automatically play on your phone, but I will show you now. Okay, let's get out of there. Let's close this. And let's start all over again. Okay, here is our joystick. And as you can see, if I just move my finger around it, it moves. Okay, now what I want to do first is actually show you what this joystick has. And it has many handlers. It has a beginning handler and a ending handler. We are not going to use that. We are going to use the tracking handler. Now, what that means is basically once you move your finger on that joystick, it actually can move our hero. So here is our handler. I will just comment maybe everything out here and move this Z rotation, because we are going to talk about that in just a moment. Let me just show you like so, and maybe move that up so you may see. Okay, now here we have our tracking handler, and we set the hero's position to our current hero's position, plus we get back some data, and on that data we have the velocity on the X angle, X value, and our Y value. And we multiply it by our velocity multiplier, basically how fast you want that sprite to move to our joystick's movements. So we have set it 0.12 for our velocity multiplier here. So we set that right. Okay, let's build and run again, and let's see how that looks. And after that, we are finally going to talk about our Z rotation. Okay, cancel that out, and let's see here what we have got. Okay, let's go in there, and now it moves. And as you can see, moves upward, downward, right and left. Pretty great. Okay, now what we want to achieve next is to have it move in the direction that we are moving our hero. Well, move the front, so maybe rotate. And that is what we are going to do. We are going to set the hero's Z rotation to our data's angular. So we get our velocity back, get our angular, and it is this simple how you can use this analog joystick framework. So let's build and run again for the last time and see that this was everything that we needed to do. Let's jump right in. And now we should see the tanks moving in the right direction. Great. Now, that is all to it. That is what you need to know to use analog joystick in your SpriteKit games. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, go ahead and take a look at Tank Quest Mania on the App Store. Download it, because it takes a lot, and maybe write a good review for our client here. Did you learn some cool stuff today? I hope you did about analog joysticks. And if you like this video, go ahead and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button down below. And while you are there, hit that notification bell so you may get notified when I release new videos. And if you want some really subscribers only stuff, go ahead and take a look at my email list on rebeloper.com. Subscribe to that for new notifications and maybe some discounts on our products. Okay, what did you like best in this tutorial? It's your turn. Go ahead and comment down below. Did you like this analog joystick, or do you have some sort of a new approach to adding a joystick in a SpriteKit game? Okay, I will see you in the next one.